Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of the National Park Service, I'd like to welcome you to Flight 93 National Memorial, and thank you for joining us today as we remember the passengers and crew of Flight 93 and their heroic actions of September 11th, 2001.
A hijacked plane crashed in Pennsylvania this morning, not far from the West Virginia border. This is one of the four planes hijacked during this morning's attack. It crashed in Somerset County, Pennsylvania, about 80 miles southeast of Pittsburgh. 13 News reporter Kane Farabaugh has more tonight from the crash scene.
We're here in Somerset County, Pennsylvania, and this is where United Airlines Flight 93 crashed earlier today, just after 9 a.m. It's not certain exactly what piece of the puzzle this airplane crash fits into the terrorism that's been happening all across the United States, most notably in New York and Washington, D.C., but details are still surfacing about this plane crash. Information is slowly seeping out and filtering from the wreck site. What we know so far is that the plane did crash. Whether it is tied in with the terrorism is still not certain. There was a 911 phone call made from the airplane shortly before it crashed. A woman was calling the 911 center to explain that the airplane had been hijacked. The airplane crashed shortly after that 911 phone call was made. Rescue crews, the FAA, the National Transportation Safety Board, and scores of investigators, media, and rescue crews from all over the United States have descended here on Somerset County, Pennsylvania, not far from the small town of Shanksville. Very soon we're going to travel down the road. We're going to be taken to the airplane crash site. What we know at the crash site so far is that not much notable exists there except for a large crater in the ground where the plane apparently made a 45-degree angle nosedive and crashed directly into the ground. Now, there were five crew members, what we know so far from United Airlines, there were five crew members, two pilots, and there were about 38 people on the airplane. At least 38 people are on the airplane. So far, no confirmation of a passenger list, no confirmation of a crew list, and there's still detail surfacing about this horrible tragedy here in the beautiful countryside of Somerset County, Pennsylvania.
We're here today to remember and honor 40 men and women who gave their lives so others could live theirs. Inspired by what happened here, 2.8 million young Americans since 9/11, that 9/11 generation, have joined the United States Armed Forces. Thousands giving their lives and tens of thousands being wounded to finish the war that began here.
Most of the elected officials are on board with the subjugation of the United States to a global system of governance. Some are actively facilitating this agenda, while others are making nominal objections on the stage of political theater, whilst hoping to earn a seat at the global table. It's entertainment for the globalists, distraction of the masses, and diversionary fodder for the talking heads in the media. America has become a captured operation, captured from within. Think of the Vichy French internal collaboration with the enemy, or softening the ground for a full takeover from within. The takeover of America has already happened. The collaborators have already been installed. And we are now on a path to complete subjugation of a larger global system of governance. If you continue to doubt this, how else would you explain the numerous examples of our dual-party governmental acquiescence of self-destruction?
И вопрос над национальной валютой. Кстати, по этому поводу могу вас порадовать. У меня в кармане лежит наднациональная валюта. Значит, которую мне положили в качестве подарка. Значит, это одна единица, тестовый экземпляр под лозунгом Unity in Diversity. Значит, и называется это международная валюта, то есть United Future World Currency. Вот она, ее уже, так сказать, можно посмотреть и потрогать.
And when I asked a senior member of the Obama administration last week, how are we going to grow exports if we won't allow nominal wage deflation? And he says, we're just going to kill the dollar. And I said, okay, more, you mean?
By its very definition, to kill our national currency is an act of high treason by those engaged in this activity. It undermines the very sovereignty and survival of our nation and will have a life-changing impact on every citizen in the U.S. It will also impact every nation and the people of every nation on the planet, as the U.S. dollar is presently the world's reserve currency. It is an act that should result in the filing of criminal charges against the conspirators, a trial of their peers, and if convicted, a death sentence. It's that serious.